Okay, before I bring back in Gaurav Rizvi, I'm going to go to Saida Muna Tasneem, who's Bangladesh's High Commissioner to the UK and Ireland. When you hear Tasneem speaking there, it's a litany. But thousands behind bars, extrajudicial killings, enforced disappearances. Must make your job quite hard defending the Bangladeshi government here in the West, here in the UK.
But Tasneem doesn't even live in Bangladesh, so, you know, he's seeing Bangladesh from outside, just like you're doing.
Why doesn't he live in Bangladesh?
I have no idea.
Okay, well, come
so,
back.
What I'm saying is that... Bangladesh definitely, you know, in the history of Bangladesh and press freedom, if you look at the 70s, 80s, 90s and 2000s, even until 2000, there was just one private TV channel. Right now, Sheikh Hasina, between 2009 and 2018, has opened up the media and 32 private TV channels every day, 90 political talk shows. Sheikh Hasina has been criticized left and right. There are newspapers criticizing Sheikh Hasina and the parliament she's been criticized. So why wouldn't Bangladesh have press freedom? She doesn't need to put anybody's voice down.
In there are also people being arrested for criticizing her too.
That's a fraction. That's a small fraction. That doesn't mean that Bangladesh doesn't have press freedom.
Before Muna Tasneem is here, the High Commissioner, what's your response when you hear, for example, it's not just atheist bloggers. There are many minorities in Bangladesh who are upset. The secretary of the Bangladesh Buddhist Federation said that when Hindus, Buddhists and Christians face abuse in Bangladesh, there is no one to turn to for justice. That's quite damning, isn't it, from minorities in your country?
It's actually quite baseless. I think Sheikh Hasina's party has been the most secular party that Bangladesh has ever witnessed. It's very clear that her policies, in her previous government, she had five cabinet ministers who are Hindus and Christian and Buddhist. And in this cabinet, she has at least three cabinet ministers, full cabinet ministers, who are Hindus and Buddhist. After the Ramu incident, if you recall, Sheikh Hasina has rebuilt 19 Buddhist temples.
There's Buddhists, though, isn't it? It's Buddhist leaders, Hindu leaders, Christian leaders. They're all saying, we feel under fire.
I wouldn't agree with that. Why does she empower women? She empowers women to marginalize extremist forces. And that is how Bangladesh is doing so well economically.
Abbas Faiz is here. Saida Muna Tasneem is here, Bangladesh's High Commissioner to the UK and Ireland. You've also served on Bangladesh's National Task Force on the repatriation of Rohingya refugees. Abbas says you've done well, but not enough.
We have done excellent. We're the only country in the world who's giving maximum protection to the Rohingyas. Why isn't the world doing enough? That should be your question, not what Bangladesh is doing enough. Bangladesh is a country which is an LDC. We are at least... Bangladesh is a least developed country. We're the most densely populated country in the world. We are sharing our food and space and sovereign space with the Rohingyas. We've given 6,000 acres of land for Rohingyas. We are protecting 60,000 women who are raped and gave babies, 70,000 babies who are rape babies. We're providing support and shelter to those babies. We're providing health, education, healthcare, prenatal, postnatal to women who are sexually violated in Rakhine State. The question is, why isn't the world doing enough? Would the United Kingdom be ready to take 1.1 million refugees? Would any other countries be ready to do that?
It's a good question. I think we know the answer.